This video is going to be about using custom fields with Elementor Pro version 2, which is right now in beta. We're going to have a short discussion on why you want to use custom fields in the first place. And then I'm going to show you how I am using or how I've gotten it to work with Elementor Pro version 2, the beta version that is, well, it's currently in beta, but they had a new beta update today. And that's what is prompting this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. And you might want to consider clicking it because you'll be joining, let me go right here, 50,160 other people that have subscribed here to the YouTube channel. Yes, yesterday when I woke up in the morning, it had hit 50,000 subscribers, which is a very nice accomplishment. I'm very happy and humbled and grateful. Okay, so here is a blog post that I saw today on an article that interests me about this new camera that is coming out later this year. And one of the things I really noticed was there's this data separation. And that's kind of how I look at using custom fields and how it might be helpful to look at it is separating off your data. Now, in WordPress today, when you go to create a blog post, for example, you put in a title and that's a separate piece of data. It's separate from the rest of the information on that blog post. And then you have the content area and that's where you pop in paragraphs and images and all that. And that is one block of data. None of it's separated. It's all just kind of scrunched on in there together. Now, when you add custom fields to the mix, it's just like having this separate pieces of data. This blog post is a great example of why you might want separate pieces of data in the first place. When we take a look, we've got the title, nothing special about that, but then we have this nice large area for this video and it's separate from everything else. And as we scroll down, then we've got this content area and then we have a sidebar here with a bunch of advertisements. And this content area here has your paragraphs and your images and all that kind of stuff. It's all kind of bundled in there together. So this is an example of data separation when you have, which is Elementor Pro version 2 is going to be giving us the ability to do whatever you want with the layout of all of your blog posts. Now, if you factor in custom fields, you can get this data separation. Now, that's my way of explaining it. There's probably a million technically more accurate ways to explain it, but I'm just talking in practical sense why someone would sit there and say, why would I want to use this in the first place, these custom fields? So let's go ahead and jump into a installation here of WordPress. So there's lots of ways of getting or creating custom fields for WordPress-based websites. One of the most popular plugins is called Advanced Custom Fields. And WordPress has a, Elementor Pro version 2 has a direct integration with Advanced Custom Fields. However, it's not the plugin that I prefer to use. There's actually several of them. There's one called Pods, and this is what I like to use. It allows you to create custom post types, and I'll make a separate video on that. And it also allows you to create these custom fields, and it also allows you to create custom fields that go along with blog posts. And that's what we're going to do in this video. And there is the granddaddy of them all. It's called Toolset. I'll put links to all this stuff down below if you want to check it out on your own anyway. Toolset is not free though. That one's paid, but you can do some amazingly advanced things with it. And Elementor has said that deeper integration is coming with Toolset. Anyway, so I've already gone ahead and activated Pods right here. And you can see I have Elementor and Elementor Pro Beta 4, which was just released today. All right, so let's get to doing this. So the first thing I want to do is create some of these custom fields. So I'm going to go to Pods. And there's nothing has been done here yet. And this is the first thing you see. So I'm not going to create a custom post type. I want to extend an existing custom, post type, which is the blogs. So, all right. So I'm going to click on extend existing And then right here, it says post type. And this is the one I want, posts, pages, etc. And then right here, it gives me the option to choose which one. So for me, it's gonna be posts. So I wanna add some of these custom fields to posts. I'll go ahead and click on next step. And it's gonna go ahead and do some of the things it needs to do. It takes me right here. I'm gonna click right there where it says add field. And all I have to do is give it a label, and then it's automatically gonna generate a name. It's gonna be all lowercase. Any spaces are gonna be replaced with underscores, and that's important. And then I can choose the field type. Now, I don't wanna make this video any longer than it needs to be. I'm just gonna create one of these fields. I'll just go ahead and do it right now. All right, I just named it product name, or if I was having a blog about cameras, I could be calling this maybe camera name or something like that. Now, the minute I hit tab, it's gonna automatically generate the name. And there's all these different field types. This is more for making sure that the formatting is correctly what gets saved. So a URL for website will only accept a properly formatted URL. I'm gonna leave it on plain text. I'm gonna click on save field just to get this done. I'm gonna click on save pod right here. And now what's gonna happen is when I go to an existing or create a new blog post, we're gonna see this new custom field where I can enter in a piece of data. So I'm gonna go to posts, and I am going to click on your Hello World post right here. And you're gonna see we have the area for our title. This is nothing new. We have the area where you put all your text. That is nothing new. But this right here is what is new. It says more fields and it says product name. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop in a product really quick. Okay, there it is, Black Magic Camera, which happens to be the camera I was looking at, a new version of that's coming out. I'm gonna click on update. So now all that I've done is added a value to this custom field. Now, if I go to create a new blog post, let's just do it to see what it looks like. I'll click on add new right there. You pop your title in, you pop your bit of content in, and then here's those more fields. And these are the custom fields that I am able to create now with pods. And so there it is. So that's gonna always be there. Okay, so this is great. We've got our blog post and we have our custom field, but here's the thing. If you look at that blog post right now on the front end of your WordPress website, you're not gonna see that data anywhere. And that's where the beauty of Elementor Pro version 2 comes in. It's gonna allow us to use Elementor to create a template that we can apply to all of our blog posts. So I'm not gonna get too detailed into it, but I just wanna show you how to use these custom fields within that. So I'm gonna go to Elementor, I'm gonna go to my templates, and I'm gonna create a brand new template. So I'm gonna click on add new template. I like this new interface for adding new templates. Right here, I'm gonna choose the type. So now you can do headers and footers, but what we're gonna choose is single, just like that. And I'll go ahead and give it a name. I just named it blog post template. I'm not feeling creative. I'll click on create template right there, and then it's gonna go ahead and create it and jump me right on in to Elementor. Okay, so there are two blog post templates that come with Elementor Pro. I'm sure they're gonna be pumping designs in here as soon as they get this out. I don't wanna use any of those, so I'm gonna just click on X, and so here we are. Now, whenever you're creating a template, there's two things you want to do. First thing is you wanna click on the little I right here, and then there's this option here for settings, and then it's gonna take us here to the preview settings. So we need to select one of our blog posts so that we can actually work with real data. So right here, it's already pre-selected posts, very good. Right here, it's already selected the Hello World post, it's very good. I'm gonna click on apply and preview. Okay, now one little caveat with getting your custom fields to be available that I noticed. Number one, you had to do this step right here where you had to set the preview settings. And number two, go ahead and click on publish. And since this is brand new, it's gonna offer us to create conditions. And this is where we're telling Elementor, we're creating this template and here's where we want it used. So I'm gonna click on add condition. And I'm gonna choose all posts. Now you could choose all blog posts in a particular category or just individual blog posts. I'm gonna just choose all of them. And then I'm gonna click on publish. This should go down. just like this. And now here's what you need to do for those custom fields to show. I've noticed I need to get out of Elementor and then jump right back in, and then I'll have those custom fields available. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the hamburger right here in the top left, click on exit the dashboard. It's going to kick me out. And now I'm just going to jump right on back in by clicking on edit with Elementor. Here I am, All right, so now let me show you some of the things that you can do. So when I scroll down here, if you have Elementor Pro version 2, you have theme elements here. And this is where I can just drag and drop in, and it's going to choose, it's just going to show the title, which was Hello World, and give you options to change it. Okay, so you have all of those there, but you don't have something down there for custom fields. Now here's where the power and beauty comes in with Elementor Pro version 2. You could take the data in those custom fields and you can put that in just about all of the modules, and not just the modules that come with Elementor and Elementor Pro. I also have on this website ultimate add-ons for Elementor installed, and it's right here, and right now it has these 8 add-ons. I can actually use that data in the add-on package if they have made it work. So I'm sure this will be coming to some of the other ones as well that are really good. The other one I like is Elementor Extras. I think that one's really good as well. Those are my two favorites. Okay, so, but I know for a fact that Ultimate Add-ons already works. Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor already works this way. So let's just go ahead and drop on in this fancy heading right here. Why not? There it is. Actually, I don't know if I want to use that one here. Let's just see. Okay, that's all right. I can use that one. Okay, so now if a module works with this custom fields that I'm talking about, you'll see it's a dynamic right above where you would normally enter a value in for the field. So when you click on dynamic, you're going to click on custom field, post custom field. And this is how it works today. It might be a little smoother and maybe listed out here in the future. Who knows? But I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And then where it says key, and this is where you're going to see a list of your custom fields. So for me, I'm going to go ahead and click on product name. And I can now click away, and there it is. You could see it pulled in that custom field where it was product name. And so here I can type some other things if I wanted to. I could get rid of here, and that's it. You could see it is working with your custom fields this way. Now I have noticed it's a little on the buggy side. So if you don't see the field showing, maybe try doing a hard refresh here in the browser. Here, let me just do a quick update. Another option to look at is with pods for the product name, or I'm sorry, the custom field. There's also this option right here that says REST API. You might want to enable that as well. But as you can see, I didn't really do anything special, and now I have that working. I can go ahead and click on the little eye here, and we can do this with other modules or elements here as well. So here is your normal heading right here with Elementor. I can do the same thing, dynamic, post custom field, select product name, and there it is as well. So this is definitely, I mean, it's a little buggy right now because this is beta, and you shouldn't run a beta version of anything on your main website. But if you are into testing, this should be a very encouraging thing to see, that it can at least see these custom fields. And it is a little on the buggy side, but I'm sure by the time it's finally released, it might work smoother and definitely a lot easier. Maybe that some of that jumping in and out won't even be needed. But this is beta. If you're watching this and you're thinking, wow, that looks kind of, I have to jump in and out and all that kind of stuff, this is beta, and it might even be unintentional for it to be working at this stage to begin with. So anyways, I can tell you, for me, I've been reaching out to someone to get help in developing a better integration, a third-party integration with pods for this, because it's what I like to use, and trying to get that and pay for that and get that put in the WordPress repository. So anyways, this is using some custom fields, just a real quick overview of why you might want to use some custom fields in the first place, as an example. And I'll be doing, just so you know what to expect, I'll be having a lot more content coming out related to Elementor Pro version 2. I just really gotta wait until it's in its final version before I make those videos and put them out there. Hey, I got links to everything in the video description box down below. Thanks for watching this video. If you found any value in it, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, I guess. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and I'll just see you in the next video.